Hey everybody, it's John here, John's DIY Playground. Today I want to take you down the rabbit's hole of home automation from the DIY side of things. There's a lot of different solutions out there and I've looked at a couple of them. One I had looked at in the past is called OpenHAB, a very good package there. Also lots to learn from that. I took it a step further and went a different way after that and got into what I'm going to show you today. And when you think of home automation, you might think like this picture here I'm showing. This guy's got a fancy pants house. Look at that crazy lighting around the ceiling. You can control that from your phone. We can do that in this system that I'm going to show you today. But you don't need a fancy pants house to enjoy home automation, and there's a lot to be gained from doing a home automation system, which I'll show you today. So let's get rid of this guy. So this is the kind of system I have right now. It's going to be growing over time. And most of these nodes, or sensors if you want to call them that, have been partially invented by me. I borrowed code from several places, read a lot of forums. I'm definitely not a software programmer, but over the years I've picked up things here and there. We'll talk about what's required from a software standpoint to do this yourself. And we'll talk a little bit about how this system works. So I do have future videos planned where I'd like to explain how these nodes are put together and how they work. There's a lot of material that could be discussed, but at this point I want to talk about the system in general so that I can dive deeper later into other things. So this is the overview of what I've got. It's really just a intranet based site on my own home network. It's a Raspberry Pi that's serving this web page up to me. And you can see I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different nodes right now. And each one will show you a simple graphic. It shows you the status of how strong the Wi-Fi signal is between the node and the gateway. It shows you the status of the last time it was updated and sent to either sent or received a command. So I have a garage door opener sensor in my garage. It can detect if the door is open or closed. It can also open or close it manually using this system. The space heater remote, not many people will probably find use in this, but it's great for me. It's extra safe redundancy for my space heater. We'll talk about that again some time in the future. Utility room sensor. This is an interesting combination of sensors that I put together. Mostly a couple of water sensors for leak detection and notification, and also something for the dryer that we'll get into at a later time. Voltage sensing just monitors the house voltage, tells me if we're in normal operating conditions or if we're going into brownout. My gateway and this sensor has battery backup protection, so even if we go into brownout or even full power out, as long as the cable modem's alive, it will stay alive and give me updates on what the voltage is. This light switch actually I purchased from the site that I'll be mentioning quite often here, lowpowerlab.com. I'll put a link to them down in the information box below the video, of course. But this is a cool light switch kit that I put together. It controls not only the light in my living room, but it also shows red or green status about my garage door if it's up or down, so at a glance I can tell what's going on with the garage door before bed. Wi-Fi thermostat, this is a different type of node in that it's a store-bought Wi-Fi thermostat, but it has an open API, so I can ask this thermostat what its status is, what the current temperature is, what the target temperature is, so on and so forth, and integrate it in with the rest of these nodes. So let's take a look at how the system is set up and what the advantages are of this type of system. So we have a web-based interface, as I mentioned, using Raspberry Pi as the gateway. We use Raspberry Pi because it's a little bit more horsepower than normal Arduinos. Arduinos are great for being sensor nodes, but to be web servers and to do other things like data collection is a little too much for them, so Raspberry Pi is also a nice cheap alternative to the Arduino and can handle the job. The features of the Motino, which is what this lowpowerlab.com sells, called Motino because it's a remote, and INO is a file name of when you're programming Arduino type files. So it's kind of a combination of Arduino and it has a transceiver in it that sends the messages back and forth. So not just an Arduino, but an onboard transceiver to send to and from each node. And what's great is we do have two-way communication, not only sending messages to the gateway, but also can send commands from our web interface to do something. Another feature that is written by the inventor of the Motino, Felix Rusu, at lowpowerlab.com, is this wireless reprogramming possible. So you get these nodes designed and built, and for example, in my garage, if you find out, okay, I need to change my code just a little bit, change the software, well, then you don't have to go out to the garage, disconnect all the hardware, bring the little Arduino back inside, take it apart, and then put the FTDI connector on it and flash it again. You can just flash over the air wirelessly using this Motino and the code that Felix has developed. Another thing you can do is act on events such as motion detection or power loss. So the Motinos send the message to the gateway. The gateway can then send a text message or an email to any phone or email account you desire. The events can be turned on or off quite easily in the interface. I can jump and show that real quick. For example, I have in the garage door opener, I'm sending SMS whenever the garage door is opened. If I don't want that to be active anymore, I just click that real quick. It'll still be there, but it turns red to show that I don't want to use that anymore at the moment. So it'll be suspended. So I'll turn that back on. The events can be scheduled to happen automatically. So if you want something to happen, for example, at 6 a.m., turn on the lights or turn on the lights at dark, off at dusk, it can do that. Logging data points and graphing them, that's also a very nice feature. The graphs they build themselves. I can show you that very quickly. For example, this is my garage door status. It's showing the door being closed. I actually have three states. When the door opens, it'll be open status, but when it's closed, it can be either car status or closed status. Depending if a car is in the garage or not, I can actually detect that using an ultrasonic sensor. And then using homemade nodes or store-bought devices, I mentioned, with open API. So it's not just limited to doing it all 100% homebrew. If you do buy something like the remote Wi-Fi thermostat I have, you can also pull that and work with remote sensors like that. So how the system works, really, it's quite simple. You have that Raspberry Pi gateway as the center of the system. I have a Motino USB. There's a couple of different types of Motinos. I'm using the USB version because it was the easiest to hook into the Raspberry Pi, which has USB ports, so I just plug it in. So it acts as the wireless receiver and talks with the same frequency to the different nodes. So here's, for example, four different nodes: my light switch, my garage door opener, the line voltage monitor, and the utility room. Each node needs to have its own unique number, and it has to know the gateway ID of the gateway, or this Motino USB here in the middle, in order for the two-way communication to take place. There's also an encryption code that has to be matching between the gateway and each node so that the messages are passed and not blocked with that encryption code. So there is some security involved here. And then if you want more information, I'll show you the website for Low Power Labs, but I wanted to basically say, for those out there going down the DIY path and thinking, is this for me or not? What do I really need to know? Here's some of the key things, I think, from a programming standpoint. The Arduino version of the C language is used for the nodes, and I think that's where the most knowledge is needed. You really need to know how the code works. There's a lot of examples out there, but it's heavy in C, and this is where the bulk of the programming that you'd have to do on your own takes place. The next thing is there's some JavaScript in the gateway. There's a lot of examples of JavaScript in the gateway files that show how things are done with, like, programming events, for example, programming new nodes. They all need to be set up one time and then you can forget about them, but you do need a little bit of JavaScript knowledge in order to set those up. And then finally, knowing a little bit about Python and Raspberry Pi for the wireless reprogram or just setting up the gateway is very, very helpful. And again, there's many tutorials that I learned from. I'm definitely no expert. And I went to the website Low Power Lab, as I mentioned many times, and looked over all this documentation. Felix has done an excellent job of detailing what the different types of Motinos are that he offers. This is kind of like the basic setup. You have to have this FTDI programmer. I just have one of these in order to program each Motino or node, so I have one of these per node. The gateway is actually this guy right here, and I only have one of these that's hooked to the Raspberry Pi. It has the mini USB connection, and that's what hooks into the Raspberry Pi as the gateway. And finally, the framework and of how the gateway works, it's all documented very well, again, by Felix on the Low Power Lab, and I'll include links in my info box below. But you can read through all of this. I won't go over it in my video. He's got a really good, his own YouTube video. And I should mention, for those that are lazy like me, he's got a really great option where he explains step by step, if you want to set it up on the Raspberry Pi, how to do every single step. But what I did is I went to this get the pre-built Pi image. So you can just download the image as a zip file, put that onto your card, and put it into your Raspberry Pi, and you're good to go as far as the gateway. So that's a really quick and easy way to get started and hit the ground running. So that's all I wanted to share for today. If you have any other questions, please leave comments below and I'll try to answer them as best I can. So thanks for watching, and I hope you found this interesting, and we'll get into more node detail in future videos. Thank you.